Hello, and welcome to the third presentation in the tutorial series, Strategies for Success Supporting DeafPlus Learners. My name is Brenda Fawcett, and I'm an assistant professor in the Department of Educational Psychology at the University of Alberta. I began my career at the British Columbia School for the Deaf in Burnaby, BC, where I taught deaf students who were diagnosed with additional disabilities such as autism, Down syndrome, and cerebral palsy. Some of my DeafPlus students demonstrated difficulty acquiring sign language skills, in much the same way that hearing students with developmental disabilities may have difficulty acquiring spoken language skills. I looked to the field of Augmentative and Alternative Communication, or AAC, to find ways to support the development of communication skills for my students. In this presentation, I will share with you some of the strategies I found useful. Before we begin looking at specific AAC strategies, I want to talk a bit about what AAC is. Augmentative and Alternative Communication, or AAC, refers to an area of research, clinical, and educational practice. AAC involves attempts to study and, when necessary, compensate for temporary or permanent impairments, activity limitations, and participation restrictions of individuals with severe disorders of speech-language production and/or comprehension, including spoken and written modes of communication. DeafPlus students may require AAC because of a physical impairment that interferes with their ability to use sign language or speech. Other DeafPlus students with developmental disabilities, such as autism, may require AAC because they may have difficulty understanding or producing signed or spoken language. For some students, AAC may facilitate the development of signed or spoken language skills. Other students may require AAC for their entire lives. It is important to understand that using AAC will not interfere with the development of signed or spoken language. This has been demonstrated in the literature. AAC provides access to communication and learning opportunities for DeafPlus students. AAC can be used to help DeafPlus students understand us. In the second tutorial in this series, I talked about visual schedule systems. This is one way AAC can be used to help students understand information. For this tutorial, I will be focusing on strategies to help students communicate expressively. In the resource section for this tutorial, you will find information regarding AAC strategies to support both receptive and expressive communication. DeafPlus students may use communication boards to communicate with others. They may do so by pointing to pictures or symbols on the board. The pictures or symbols typically have a printed word or phrase that helps others know what the image means. Communication boards can be topic specific. That means that one board will have vocabulary related to one topic only, such as art. Communication boards can be arranged in a binder, and index tabs can be used to help students locate specific pages more quickly. Communication boards are most useful for students with motor impairments or students with mild to moderate intellectual disabilities who understand the need to gain the attention of communication partners before pointing to symbols. Students with autism, for example, tend not to do as well with communication boards because they tend not to understand the need to gain the attention of the communication partner first. They may point to symbols on a communication board without anyone else around or looking and think that they are communicating a message. The Picture Communication System, or PECS, is an instructional program designed to teach children to initiate communication-based interactions. It was developed initially for students with autism, but can be used with other individuals as well. PECS follows a very specific instructional protocol. To implement PECS, you must have proper training. There's more information about this in the reference section. You can also go to www.pecs.com for information regarding PECS and to see when there will be a training in your area. With PECS, students are taught to give a picture or symbol to a communication partner. The communication partner then responds to the message. For example, if a student wants a cookie, he would select the symbol for cookie, go to the person who has the cookie, and give that person the symbol. The person would then respond by giving the student a cookie. Over time, students are taught to combine symbols to create sentences, such as, "I want cookie." Initially, students are taught to request things they like. Over time, they are taught to make comments as well as request other items. Most of the research related to PECS has involved hearing children with autism. However, there is one published study that involves a deaf Greek boy with autism. This boy had deaf parents but had not acquired Greek sign language, even though that is what his parents used at home. This is similar to what happens with many hearing children with autism. They have difficulty acquiring language. This boy was taught to use PECs following the protocol developed by Dr. Andy Bondi and Laurie Frost. Over time, this boy learned to use PECs to communicate effectively, and he then began using Greek Sign Language. In my own experience teaching deaf students with autism, I have found PECs to be very effective in developing communication skills in general. Not all students will acquire signed or spoken language skills, but they will be able to communicate effectively. Conversation books are used to support individuals in sharing information with others. Typically, we will use a small photo album and build the conversation book with the student. For example, during the school day, the student may have made an art project, written a journal entry, and played hockey in gym. The teacher or classroom assistant may have taken photographs of the student engaged in these activities and printed them. Near the end of the day, the student and classroom assistant could sit together and place each of the photographs in the conversation book. The classroom assistant could then help the student write simple sentences to describe each photograph. For example, the caption, "I made a painting in art class. I used blue, green, and yellow paint. Do you like to paint?" could be included with the photograph of the student painting a picture. When the student goes home, she can then show the conversation book to her parents. A conversation book can help students share information with others and can also provide a basis for ongoing conversation. For example, the parents might then ask questions about the student's painting while looking at the photograph with their daughter of her making a painting in class. There are many, many AAC options. The most important thing is to select AAC strategies and interventions that best match the student's strengths and needs. It's best to work with a professional, such as a speech-language pathologist or AAC specialist. In the resource section for this tutorial, you will find a number of resources to help you get started.